Good day, students. Welcome to part one of the Fundamental Theorem of Calculus, part one. In this installment, we're going to be going over three examples. To get started, let's write down what the Fundamental Theorem of Calculus, part one is. FTC, part one, tells us that if f, function f, is continuous on a closed interval AB, then the antiderivative written by uppercase F of x is equal to the integral from A, some A to x, of F of t dt. Okay? And also, the derivative of the antiderivative f of x is given by the derivative of the antiderivative expressed in the integral form, which is the integral from a to x of f of t dt is equal to f of x. Okay? This circum formula just illustrates the inverse relationship between the antiderivative and the derivative. So if you differentiate the antiderivative, you end up with the original function that you started with. Okay? Now let's take a look at the following. The instructions are for us to find dy dx. For number one, let's say we have a function y given as an integral from 3 to x squared of sine t dt. Okay? All right, let's take a look at this function. If we examine the FTC part 1, we'll notice that the argument of the integrand is f of x, or in this case, f of t. Okay, so in this situation right here, f of t is equal to sine t. Okay, let's go ahead and find the antiderivative of this. So we're going to have y equals, the expression for the antiderivative of lowercase f is uppercase f of uppercase f of t. And now we're going to be making use of FTC part 2. I'll show you what that is in a second. So uppercase f of t evaluated from 3 to x squared. Okay? Do you remember what FTC part 2 is? Well, let's write that down on the side. FTC part 2 tells us that if you take a definite integral from a to b of f of x dx, it's equal to the antiderivative of lowercase f, which is uppercase f, evaluated at b, minus the antiderivative of f, lowercase f, which is uppercase f, evaluated at a. So this difference is equivalent to that. Okay, this is FTC 2. So we're going to be using FTC 1 and 2 for these problems. All right, so setting it up like this, using FTC part 2, what we'll do is we'll plug in the upper limit of integration, and then minus the lower limit of integration. So this is going to become the antiderivative of f evaluated at x squared minus the antiderivative of f evaluated at 3. Okay? So this is what y looks like using FTC part 2. Now what are we asked to find? We're asked to find dy dx. Okay, so let's find dy dx. To do that, we'll just simply differentiate this function we have here. So dy dx is equal to d dx of this expression, uppercase antiderivative of f at x squared minus antiderivative of f at 3. Okay? So this is going to become, now when you differentiate the antiderivative, you end up with the original function. You notice here d dx of f of x, uppercase f of x is f of x, so this is going to become f of x squared. Now we have to use the chain rule here since the input is a function. Derivative of x squared is 2x. okay, minus the derivative of uppercase f of x. The derivative of the antiderivative is a function, so it's lowercase f of 3, times the derivative of 3, which is 0. Okay? Now let's go ahead and simplify this. This becomes 2x. Now what is f of x squared? If f of t is sine t, f of x squared will simply be what? It will be sine of x squared. Right? So you just simply replace this t, which is the input, with x squared, and you have that. And then this minus 0, and your final answer is simply 2x sine x squared. Okay? Now let's use a let me show you a shortcut. You don't have to do all this work to get the final answer. I just want to show you how it works. But if you want to use a shortcut, anytime you have a variable and a constant, to find the derivative of an antiderivative expression like this, all you simply do is you input the variable limit. If the upper limit is a variable, you just input that into the function. You're going to have sine of x squared, as we have here. Multiply that by the derivative of that variable limit that you inputted, which is 2x. And there goes your final answer. The constants piece, you don't bother with that, because when you differentiate it using the chain rule, it becomes 0 and that portion drops off. Okay, so if I wanted to do this real quick without doing all this work, I just take x squared, plug it in here, that gives me sine x squared, and I do not forget the chain rule, multiply this by the derivative of that, which is 2x, and there goes your final answer. You can do it in less than a second, okay? All right, let's take a look at another example. Question number 2. So we have, in this case, y equals the integral from cosine x to 4 of the square root of 1 minus t squared minus t squared dt. Okay? Now, if you want to use a shortcut, in this case, the variable is downstairs, so you're going to end up with a negative result, since you're going to have 0 minus this expression. So, can you see what the answer is? The answer is simply going to be the square root of 1 minus cosine square x times negative sine x, since the derivative of sine x is negative sine x. The derivative of cosine x is negative sine x, right? And then you have the minus in front, so you just simply have sine x times the square root of 1 minus cosine square x. That'll be your final answer. But let me show you the steps. Let's go through all the steps, okay? In this situation, the integrand is f of t. All right, f of t in this case is the square root of 1 minus t squared, okay? Now, so y equals the integral from cosine x to 4 of the square root of 1 minus t squared dt. Using FTC part 1, this is going to be uppercase f of t, okay? And we're going to use FTC part 2 to evaluate this from cosine x all the way to 4, all right? So FTC part 2 just requires us to plug in the upper limit of integration minus the lower limit. All right, so we have uppercase of f, the antiderivative of f at 4, minus the antiderivative of f at cosine x. Okay? Now this is y. We're asked to find dy dx. So how do we find dy dx? We just simply differentiate what we have here. So we're going to be looking for d dx of y. Y is the antiderivative of x, which is for f of 4 minus f of cosine x. Write that again, cosine x. Okay. All right. So we're going to use term-by-term differentiation to evaluate this. The first piece, the derivative of f of the antiderivative of f of 4 is going to be lowercase f of 4 times the derivative of 4, which is 0, minus the derivative of uppercase F is lowercase f of cosine x times the derivative of cosine x. Do not forget the chain rule, please. The derivative of cosine x is negative sine x. And we can clearly see that our answer here is going to be, let me do the steps so you see everything. Negative sine x. Now what is negative f of cosine x? This is f of t right here. Whatever the input is, you take the square root of 1 minus the input square. So it's going to be the square root of 1 minus cosine square x. Okay? Now, we had a minus there before. This minus, let's bring it down here. So if you simplify it, our final answer is going to be sine x times the square root of 1 minus cosine square x. Okay? And then we can even simplify this further using identities, because we know that sine square x plus cosine square x equals 1. So 1 minus cosine square x is equal to sine square x. So this is equal to sine x times the square root of sine square x, which equals sine x, and your final answer will simply be sine square x. Okay? So that's that. All right, let's take a look at question number 3. Okay? So question 3, we are to find f prime of x. Let's find f prime of x, where f prime of x is equal to the integral from x squared to sine x of the square root of t divided by 1 plus 2e to the t dt. Okay? In this situation, it's going to be a little bit longer because we do not have any zero piece, because we have variables on both sides. So when we use the chain rule, we're not going to have zero because these are not constants. Okay. All right. So this one would just involve us plugging in the upper limit times its derivative minus plugging in the lower limit times its derivative, and that will be the final answer. All right. So let's go ahead and do it. In this situation, the integrand is lowercase f of t, which is the square root of t, divided by 1 plus 2e to the t. Okay? Now we're looking for f prime of t, which is basically the derivative. So dx of uppercase f of x, the derivative of the antiderivative, is d. Let's apply the fundamental theorem of calculus part 2 here. So d dx of what f of x is, uppercase f of x, which is the integral from x squared to sine x, root t divided by 1 plus 2 e to the t dt. To make it easier for us to apply FTC part 1, I'm going to use FTC part 2 to evaluate this integral component, all right? So let's evaluate that first. So the integral, which is basically f of uppercase f of x again, the integral from x squared to sine x of the square root of t divided by 1 plus 2e to the t dt is going to be the antiderivative of lowercase f, which is uppercase f, evaluated at the upper limit, sine x, minus the antiderivative evaluated at the lower limit, x squared. Okay? So this is how to rewrite this integral using FTC part 2. Okay? Now we're going to differentiate this. Let's go ahead and differentiate that. So we're going to be looking, so f prime of x, using that notation, is going to be bracket f of sine x minus f of x square prime. All right? So now we're going to use term-by-term differentiation. This one, if we differentiate the antiderivative, we'll end up with the lowercase function. Okay, using FTC part one, the derivative of the antiderivative is a function. So we have lowercase f of sine x. Now we have to use a chain rule. The derivative of sine x is cosine x. Minus, in this case, if we find the antiderivative of uppercase f, that gives us lowercase f of x squared. Apply the chain rule times 2x. Okay? Now let's figure out what these functions are. But before we go on, you notice that this is different from the other one because since we do not have any constants, we have both parts of the antiderivative present. Okay? So f of sine x is what you get when you plug in sine into t in our f of t function here. So we're going to have the square root of sine x over 1 plus 2e to the sine x times this derivative, which is cosine x. Let's put that right here. That's for this portion, the upper limit of integration, minus f of x squared is evaluating this function at x squared. So it's going to be the square root of x squared divided by 1 plus 2e to the what? To the x squared. All right, don't forget the chain rule. If you differentiate x squared, we have 2x right there. Okay? All right, let's make this pretty. To do that, we're going to rewrite this as cosine x. Cosine x times the square root of sine x divided by 1 plus 2e to the sine x. And then minus, now the square root of x squared is x. If we multiply that by 2x, we have 2x squared divided by 1 plus 2e to the x squared. All right? You can combine them if you want. So this is basically what the value of f prime of x is. All right? So that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to my channel, and please post a comment to let me know what you think about this clip. More clips can be found on mygoserve.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.